growing up in the 70s and 80s and being a young man in the 90s and the 2000s and on, I've never seen such fierce anti-Second Amendment efforts in this country. It's only getting worse, and the fighting's getting worse. Anytime the Supreme Court goes with the Second Amendment, the anti-Second Amendment effort doubles down. It's very fierce, and I want to take a moment and just point at some facts that will show you that the driving argument for anti-Second Amendment community is to get rid of the gun, essentially prevent me from acquiring guns, especially certain guns. Now, so I want to take a moment and say, okay, what would happen, what does happen in states that have the most guns versus the states that have the least privately owned guns when it comes to crime? Because if you're trying to take away the guns, will the disappearance of guns somehow stop crime or slow it down? Will it decrease crime? Or will the presence of more guns somehow increase crime? Well, let's take a look at it. Because the top five states in this country with the most guns per capita, the top five states with the most guns have by far the least gun crime. As a matter of fact, the top five states, if you combine them all together, all of them together, and you took all of their gun crime and put it as one number, it equals 0.8% of the gun crime in America is the five states with the most guns. What we're looking at is Montana, Wyoming, Alaska, Idaho, and West Virginia. These are the five states with the most guns per 100 people. And yet, here they are with 0.8, not even 1% of the gun crime. And that's all of them combined. Not just one of them, that's all of them combined. Now let's look at the states with the least amount of guns. Now, these states, we'll start, New Jersey is in it. New York is in it. Massachusetts is in it. So these states have the highest level of gun crime, but yet they have the least guns. Now, what is going on here? Because ultimately, you take New Jersey, for example. New Jersey, 9% of violent gun crime takes place in New Jersey in this whole country. Almost 10%, 1/10 of the entire country's violent crime comes from that one single state. And New Jersey has the least guns of every state in the entire country. It is number 50 when it comes to guns per capita. You know, and you also have states like Hawaii, which, by the way, is getting worse violently. If you know anybody that lives in Hawaii, or you just Google the gun crime in the cities in Hawaii lately, it's awful. And then you have Rhode Island, which is probably kind of null and void of this data, but there you go. I mean, the five states that have the most guns, put them all together, you don't even have 1% of the gun crime. The one state that has the least guns makes up almost 1/10 of the gun crime in the entire country. It's pathetic. So, I mean, anybody who is anti-Second Amendment that happens to see this video, you should open your eyes and go, well, wait a second. What's going on here? Why is it? Well, because guns keep people friendly. Guns make people kind of second guess who they're going to attack. If somebody's going to violently attack somebody, they're not going to pick a guy with a gun on his hip. That is for sure. They're going to pick the easiest, most pathetic target they can find, which is going to be a weak person who's not paying attention and has no ability to protect themselves. So when you have no ability to protect yourself, and by the way, I always feel like, you know, I'm kind of a guy who can protect myself with or without a gun, but as I get older, and especially as I look at my parents and my older siblings aging, I'm like, they're not going to be able to protect themselves much longer here pretty soon if they don't have a firearm. They suddenly become easier targets as you get older. It's something that we have to just open our eyes to. And again, I know I'm preaching to the choir here, but if you are an anti-Second Amendment person, or for some reason you think we need to get rid of this gun, that gun, whatever, well, hello? What's going to happen? You think the criminals are going to get rid of theirs? No, of course not. That is why there is more violent crime in the states with the least amount of guns. New Jersey's the worst example in this country. Any thoughts or insight, definitely put that below. Would like to take a moment, say most people watch this channel, they're not subscribers to the channel. Please take a moment, hit that subscribe button. Greatly increases the algorithm and our ability to get these messages out. That link is below. But the most important part of this channel, we take prayer requests. Never hesitate to send that in. Thank you for watching this episode of God, Family, and Guns. And as always, love God, love your family, love guns.